Let's talk about the music industry and how it is totally being changed by AI. If you're interested, sweet. So, obviously, we know AI is a factor, right? So, with AI, you can make instrumentals of various genres using different websites like Suno.ai and other ones. Also, let's see. You can write your own lyrics, which is basically a poem, and you can copy and paste your lyrics into a music AI website, and it can generate the vocal melody and the singer and the instrumental and everything like that. So all you have to do is just be a poet and write a poem. An AI can turn it into a song. And then you can also just have a song title and you can just type in the song title and the genre or the mix of genres, and it'll generate a song according to your song title. So, obviously this has taken the internet by storm as well. So I just want to share some of my observations and make a couple predictions for fun. Right, so if you have ever checked out my album that I released in seven songs, it's called God Wave. I generated all of those instrumentals through AI, which is cool because I own the copyright and, AI will do a million times better generating instrumentals than I will. So that's my justification for using AI. So let's say that you're in the same position, but let's say you don't know how to play guitar and you're not a good singer, but you are a poet and you have written a couple songs. And you're just curious, and these other things that are required to make a song happen are not in your skill set. So that's your justification. So you're like, ah, boom, there you go. All right, so anyone can basically generate a song in various formats. That's established. That is not going away. Right? So how does this take form in all these different, how is this going to be used? How is this being used? So there's a web, there's a music channel that I discovered. There's two music channels that I discovered that are clearly just generating music through AI and then using AI to make the cover art as well. It's like obvious. One of them is like this cat channel. So it's basically just funny songs about cats. And that's it. It's music about cats. And it's like got funny AI like made like images of cats with headphones on. And so if you're just totally cat crazed and you're just a cat person, you may want to, for fun, occasionally throw on the cat channel, the cat music channel. And it really makes no difference to you whether or not it's an actual person that's singing it or not, or whether or not it's a person that wrote the lyrics. All you care about is that it's about cats. And this is the only way, this is unique and interesting, and it's the only place that you can go to for cat music 24/7. Interesting, fun, kind of catchy cat music too. All right, so there's that. There's other one that, by the way, the cat channel has like 10,000 subscribers. So there are people that are into it. And it doesn't matter to them whether or not it's a person playing the guitar or a person singing. It just straight out doesn't matter. So there's this other one that impacted me today. It's this music band, AI band. It's called Eagle Wing. And so it's basically just like a Republican patriot music. And clearly using AI to generate song titles, I mean, generate song images. But I was listening to some of the songs and I was like, they were like country songs. And I was like, I know this is AI, but I like this song. I kind of like it. Could I like it more if it didn't sound so much like AI? Yeah. But this Eagle Wing, it's called, has like something like 9,000 subscribers or something like that. And it's all basically just, I can tell that this person that's generating it sometimes just lets AI generate all the lyrics, but sometimes also writes the lyrics. And you can tell because the lyrics that the person writes, sometimes they don't flow together very well, but the AI has made it work melodically, which is interesting. So I guess, so does it matter to me? Is the question. So I'm listening to Eagle Wing, a couple songs while I'm eating some tacos. Does it matter to me in this moment whether or not it's a person? No, it doesn't matter. And so I think when we get to a point when AI gets to a point to where it sounds like you literally cannot tell that it's AI, that won't be a factor, but it's just a factor right now because it's new. But check this out now. Check this out. This was an idea that I had. So let's say this Eagle Wing or this cat person, cat channel, or you name it. It could be sneakers, just basically sneaker. It could be anything. You could just generate entire catalogs through with AI about something. And there's somebody out there that's crazy about sneakers. And so if they stumble across your music, they're gonna be stoked on your sneaker songs. So it's like, okay, there's a use for it. And do the listeners necessarily care that it's a human being? No, not. It depends on the circumstance. So let's take this Eagle Wing one, for example. Let's say Eagle Wing generates this like 200 song catalog, 500 song catalog, 1,000 song catalog, and it's all been released. And then they look at the analytics for the most played songs, which songs are the ones that people like the most. And you know which ones they like the most because those are the ones that people have played, right? And so greatest hits is basically the deal. So then put out all these songs and then establish a greatest hits. And then this is where it gets interesting. Then take a singer like, say, John Rich. Or I think his name is John Rich, the guy who's got that new song Revelation out. Or take any famous singer. Take like Post Malone. And then, Post Malone basically sings all of, now not an AI Post Malone, but the actual Post Malone, and then the Post Malone actually is up there performing it. It's like, oh my gosh. So then Post Malone sings the greatest hits. You know what I'm saying? So like it could potentially, a channel could potentially grow a niche channel like sneakers, hats, patriot music, Christian music, liberal music, hair, just whatever, makeup, workout music. And it could potentially grow to a point to where it has like a really significant following, a catalog gets built. And then the channel owner hires a super famous singer to and a producer to sing the actual songs, and it would just take it to a whole new level. And that's just super interesting to me. And also like the person who's generating all the AI owns all the copyright. And in the music industry, that's really like kind of all they care about. That's why there's like seven writers on one song, because everyone's trying to be a part of the writing process so they can get credit, so they can get royalties. And so music industry people, they just care the most. Songwriters care the most about the royalties. And so anyway, I just find that very interesting that we could see that happen. Maybe that's my idea. Maybe I came up with it first. But I could see more and more of these types of channels getting popped up that are popping up that are like really niche topics, and they're kind of funny and quirky and just have to do only with that thing. And there's people that are, it comes on occasionally. In the world of music, you've got your playlist and you listen to all sorts of stuff, and you don't necessarily only listen to one person, So, but then all of a sudden your cat song pops up and you get a laugh out of it. And it has a place in your playlist next to whoever else you listen to. And I think that's super interesting. And then one last thing as well is I could also see kind of like, people just using, say, like Alexa or whatever, and just saying, hey, generate me a 10 song EP album or a 5 song EP about the following things, and these following things happen to be what you're dealing with. Like, I'm going through a breakup, it's really hard, or like, and then we're gonna go to a vacation, and then we're gonna, I just bought this car, it's a Lexus, I love it, it's got leather interior, and put together a 5 song EP for me, and that way, so you do that because these are all the things that are actually going on in your life, because these are the things that are really you're intimately relate to, right? And then so you just tell Alexa to do it, and then boom, you got your 5 songs, and then you listen to them, and it sounds like exactly like, it just sounds amazing, and then you jam out. You jam out to this music, and the music is really just tailored, like fine-tuned, tailored to you, like your clothing, or your shower routine. You got the body wash you like the best. You got the face wash you like the best. You got deodorant you like the best. It's all completely customized to you, and I could totally see that like happening super soon, and how that will impact people's opinion, impact the way that people interact with music. And it just makes sense that music is, I'm shooting a video, baby. It just makes sense that music is like always evolving, So, the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, auto-tune. Now there's hardly any guitar songs, and just the way things change. So it's music's always changing. So, it's going to change. That's just the thing. But how it's going to change is super interesting, and how the culture reflects how it's changing. So, I don't know if you're interested in pondering these things. I hope this video is a lot of fun for you. So, keep an eye out for the cat channels, man. Trust me.